Well, I think what sets Lympstone Manor apart is that it's the imagination, if you like, and creativity of myself. It's a realisation of my dream. We have 28 acres, we have a vineyard in 10.5 of them, 17,500 vines have been planted. It's given me a platform to cook the food I want and to create the kind of hotel experience and hospitality experience which I want to be representative of the way I'd like to see a hotel treat the guests for the 21st century. One of the things that differentiates Lympstone Manor is that we're in a much more accessible part of the county. We've got the population of the largest town, Exmouth, literally 5 minutes away. So I started an academy about 8 years ago at Exeter College, the Michael Caines Academy for Excellence in Hospitality. So it's not just about chefing, it's also about front of house. So they have these days where they have experiences, and that will include going off to an abattoir, meeting suppliers. It's really important that we show young people the full potential of the industry. Obviously, since opening Lympstone Manor and being so close now to Exeter, we're even seeing more academy students choose to come and work here. The best advice I can give to any young person would be to understand that not a lot has changed in the industry. The demands are still the same. It is, unfortunately, by definition, slightly unsocial. It's important too that if you don't ask, you'll never get. So if you want to work for some of the best chefs in the industry, knock on the door. So the dish which I'm going to be cooking, best end of lamb. The lamb is from Powderham Castle, which is literally over the river. That lamb is just coming out of the new season now. We insist that the lamb is hung 2 weeks. We're going to cook that lamb, best end, using water bath technique, where it's going to be cooked for an hour and a half in 55 degrees, and then we're going to roast it back through the oven. We're going to use a basil and mustard pesto on the top of that with a herb crumb. I'm going to serve that a roast fondant potato, ratatouille, and also smoked aubergine puree with a split lamb jus, so it's like a jus roti on there as well, some roasted garlic and some caramelised grillo and onions using balsamic. We can work with the farming community, work with our butcher, to ensure we get the quality of meat that we want, that it's hung correctly, and that it's butchered to the way that we want it done. We do a lot of butchery in-house as well, but we can work with our partners to ensure that we get the best produce. So I've been championing Southwest and local produce ever since I started at Gidley Park, and it was very obvious to me how lucky we were in Devon to have a wonderful larder. We're surrounded almost by sea. This glut of ingredients, Devon being the third largest county in the UK and also one of the biggest food producing regions, have always made that a centrepiece of our menu in terms of provenance, where it's from. And I can say that our lamb is only from a few miles away.